All right, before we get started, quick shout out to DataDock Meetup. That is a little event here in Berlin where I was invited to give my little presentation on Google Analytics 4. And we had a little discussion round, a little round of presentations around the future of Google Analytics on that meetup, along with other speakers here. And the format is quite unique because you only get 10 minutes to talk. Great questions at the end, great audience as well. And obviously you can network. If you are in the area of Berlin, then check out the DataDock event. If you are just online and want to join this online, they actually also live stream it. So you can join hybrid, just go to the LinkedIn page and sign up to the next event. So thanks again for DataDock for inviting me and Pandata for hosting us with this great event. And now let's dive into my presentation on Google Analytics 4. Did Google overplay their hand with Google Analytics 4? Why should you switch or not switch to Google Analytics 4? Here are my thoughts. So first of all, Google has acknowledged that the internet has changed, consumer behaviors change, the environment has changed, and Google really had to make a move with their tool of Google Analytics. They had outdated tech, especially when it came to having different devices tracked. They wanted to have something that is goes with the times and also helps the users to really understand their website visitors, but also their app visitors. And they want to play to their strengths because they have invested billions into machine learning or AI. They're one of the leaders worldwide to bring out new things in this development, and they know that it's the future. And obviously they want to also port that over to their advertising business and Google Analytics as well. So they really need to have the database in order to analyze the data with their machine learning capabilities. So that's why Google Analytics 4 was also introduced. But the biggest reason is probably privacy. Privacy has changed so much. The conception of privacy and the view on privacy has changed so much over the last few years that really Google had to make this big, big move. There is still legal trouble ahead. We have GDPR, CCPA, many other privacy legislations that are coming out worldwide that are aimed at making sure that users' privacy is upheld. And Google is one of the targets oftentimes when I think about these laws. So that is one reason why Google really had to change something, as well as there's less data available. Now we have cookie banners up in Europe, cookie consent banners. We have private platforms entering the market with do not track kind of notices, and consumer behaviors frankly also changed. They are sick of being followed around the internet, and ad blocking is quite prevalent, and that's why less data is available, and Google needed to react to this thing as well in the realms of privacy, as well as their own deadline that they have given themselves by saying, hey, we will get rid of third-party cookies. And nowadays, I don't see any kind of real equivalent of how they can do that. This doesn't really concern Google Analytics per se because it's first-party cookie, but if we look at third-party cookies as a staple of tracking mechanisms for retargeting, for advertising systems to do conversion tracking and so on, there needs to be a fundamental shift in the technology, and that will probably also impact how Google Analytics is doing things. So then they come along with Google Analytics 4. Is it the savior that we are all waiting for? Well, marketing says, sure it is. We have new measurement. We can now take our old tech and replace it and track all the new things into one interface, app plus web. And we have a new data model that makes this all more flexible. Any kind of business type that you want to track is available in GA4. We also have new features like funnel analysis, or flexible funnels that you have, audience triggers, many different other new little features that were not possible with the data model beforehand are now built into Google Analytics 4. Anomaly detection, for example, some machine learning as well. We have privacy controls, so that should appease the privacy people quite a bit, because we can delete data now, we can turn on Google signals based on different countries, and be very flexible with our data gathering and have the right privacy controls in place. We can take ownership of our data, so we don't have to keep our data in Google Analytics. We can actually export it to something like BigQuery, or to BigQuery really, and from there we could put it out to any other form that we want to have it in, any other database. And this is really cool because we are now taking ownership of our own data. Google Analytics doesn't actually want our data because we get our data deleted in the free version after 14 months maximum. And obviously the machine learning, really cool that they are now able to take our data and build predictive audiences, do anomaly detection and so on it. That's what they wanted all along. But, and there's always a but in the sentence, we all know that Google Analytics is not what it says it is, really. We still have much legal trouble ahead, especially here in Europe. People are already saying that, well, even if you switch to Google Analytics 4, you won't be compliant. All of the mechanisms that they have built in, there may be a little bit of a plaster on the wound, but it's not really healing the wound in a sense. So that's something that you need to be aware of. Do you want to be still in a legal kind of nirvana with Google Analytics 4 and not knowing if you're gonna get sued or not? Or do you want to maybe look for an alternative there? At the same time, the UI or everything that's built into GA4 with the UI, some stuff is still very buggy. We have inconsistencies in the data, which is the biggest thing for people who work seriously with data. If you look into the data one to the other day, it might change. If you look into data from BigQuery to the UI, it might not stack up, or the APIs that you have available. You always see inconsistencies in the data. So how can you make up your mind with the data pool of GA4? And then there are many missing features, which we could talk about, but probably depending on the person who you're asking, they might have different other lists out there that they would like to see in GA4. And then we have this forced deadline, right? All the marketers out there, all the people who need to deal with this change now, the website owners, think like, why are they doing this? Why is it so prevalent that we have to switch over by July 1st, 2023, especially when the product is not yet done? This is something that puts a lot of people under pressure and they don't like it. And then there are switching costs. Obviously, you need to get everybody involved, get a team together to switch it over, because Google Analytics is not Google Analytics 4. It's not an upgrade to your old Google Analytics. It is a completely new tool. You need to reintegrate it. You need to think about the strategies of your measurement strategy. And maybe you need to get a consultant in and this do a re-implementation project. This might cost quite a bit depending on the size of the company or the installation that you are dealing with. So all of these are kind of the factors that marketers right now are saying, what am I doing here with Google Analytics 4, right? Or if they already had to deal with Google Analytics 4 and had to implement it, and now they're dealing with a mess inside of Google Analytics 4. It's quite frustrating and I get it. Yet, I'm kind of a fan of Google Analytics 4, but maybe for a different reason, because there is a great gift within the basket that Google gave us with Google Analytics 4. And it's the simple fact that we are now need to think. And a lot of people are now going into thinking mode when they see and hear about Google Analytics 4. And that's a great thing. Although it's sometimes numbing and you don't kind of foresee what can actually be done with Google Analytics 4 or what you actually have to think about, it is a great feature, especially for those who are helping other people out with implementations. We help clients out as well as students to get this all set up and get the right thinking around Google Analytics 4. So what if Google Analytics is actually not the go-to analytics tool anymore? What does that change for you? Because we have some great alternatives out there. There are, depending on the size of the business, if you are smaller, if you are bigger, there are some great alternatives out there and you might want to switch over. But even then, you need to think about, what is my data actually all about? Where should I put this in place? And which tool should I use in the end? And by the way, on this slide, you see that there are many different alternatives. There's not one the alternative, so I can't answer the question, what should I switch to? It depends on your business, obviously. And these are all alternatives that you could choose from. Google Analytics is not, there's no tool that can replace Google Analytics entirely at this point, I would say, just because all function a little bit different, have a different scope of the offerings that they have, and maybe also one or the other aspect might be more important to you, like privacy, for example. So if you are thinking about switching what Google Analytics for, I think you are on the right path there, or if you are thinking about switching away from Google Analytics for, because you need to ask yourself the most fundamental questions of data. How important is my data actually to me and my organization? What do we use it for? What data do I really need to do my daily work? How can I turn my data into actionable insights later on? Or for example, is my data privacy compliant with all the laws that are out there? These are all fundamental questions that I try to get people to think about even before Google Analytics 4 came along. But it was always a little bit hard to make them think about this stuff because it was so tool-centered. So I really appreciate Google Analytics 4. Did they overplay their hand? Did Google overplay their hand with Google Analytics 4? Yes. I think it's kind of hard to say how it will play out. But right now, it seems like Google Analytics 4 is not as well perceived and maybe not be so dominant anymore in the future. Nonetheless, I still love Google Analytics 4 for making us think about the real questions. So thank you very much. My name is Julian. I run a company called Measure School. We teach people around everything around Google Analytics, Google Analytics 4, a Data Studio, and Google Tag Manager, and you can find us at measureschool.com as well as on YouTube. And if you want to connect with me, I'm on LinkedIn as well. So thank you very much, and I'm happy to take any of your questions. All right, thank you so much to the DataDock team for letting me give this presentation in front of a little audience there. And I'd love to hear from you, your thoughts as well, down below in the comments. And if you want to learn more about Google Analytics 4, we have a playlist right here. And I can also recommend this video right here, where you learn how to set up a landing page report inside of GA4. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.